breathing. Breathing is the first thing we do when we're born and the last thing we do before we die. We can stay alive for long periods without eating, drinking, or sleeping. But if we cannot breathe, we die within a few minutes. Oxygen cannot be stored. It must be replenished continuously and steadily. Once inhaled, the oxygen makes its way to the lungs and hitches a ride with the red blood cells. Oxygen gains access to the body's cells through an internal network of vessels. Your heart is a champion. It works nonstop 24/7. Your heart electrifies itself, maintains blood pressure, and acts as the major pump to get your blood moving. The heart, together with the entire network of vessels, are known collectively as the circulatory system. Although it's easy to think of these vessels as a glorified plumbing system found behind the walls in your home, blood vessels are actually active, dynamic organs capable of contracting and expanding as they deliver nutrients and oxygen, carry away waste products, and help maintain blood pressure. Along the way and further from the heart, the blood vessels become smaller and smaller, like branches of a tree. By the time blood reaches these small areas, the big pump and push that the heart supplied could use a little help before reaching their target tissues. And though it may appear as if the blood doesn't have to travel far at all, the blood vessels, if strung together, would equal a length of 100,000 kilometers, or 75,000 miles. That's enough to go around the globe nearly 2.5 times. So the pump and vessels together make a closed system that begins and starts at the heart. The same 5 liters of blood cycles through your body all day, every day. To make this long journey, our blood vessels rhythmically contract and relax. This greatly assists the delivery of oxygen and nutrient-rich blood to all organs and tissues. This vasodilation process is vital to normal functioning of our entire body. Every part of our body needs blood to deliver oxygen and nutrients. And just like the trash man, we need blood to take away all the built-up wastes, such as carbon dioxide and lactic acid. The rhythmic vasodilation and vasoconstriction doesn't always work as well as it should. Lifestyle factors and age can play a role, slowing down the heart's important helper. Diet, exercise, sleep, and how many candles on your birthday cake are all contributing factors. What happens is, because the contractions of the smaller blood vessels aren't occurring as frequently, there is less oxygen and nutrients being delivered to organs and tissues. This also means there is less waste being removed. Over time, this can lead to dysfunction. If the dysfunction accumulates for a long enough period, many cells and tissues become chronically stricken with waste buildup. In addition, these tissues are also forced to contend with prolonged lack of nutrition. You may start to notice this in a variety of ways, such as a lack of energy, poor fitness, and challenged sleep routines. Beamer therapy devices promote the foundation for health, and for more than 2 decades have been developing patented technology aimed at providing a non-invasive, non-chemical mechanism for the improvement of blood flow.